All right, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, you know, I love pivot tables. They're the most powerful feature in Excel. I've written a couple of books about pivot tables. All of my books mention pivot tables. But I got a call this week from someone who wanted to create a pivot table, and initially I just thought, there's no way that we'll ever be able to create a pivot table to solve this. They had text. It was just a huge database of text, and they wanted to be able to look for certain criteria and figure out which text entries match the criteria. And I said, you know, let's use the auto filter. And our manager said, no, I don't want to use an auto filter. I want to use a pivot table. And so this is what we did. We started out with this data set, data, pivot table, finish. And I took the title, the text that they wanted to return, and instead of putting it in the data area, I put it over here in the drop row fields here. So there's a list of all of the items. Now, in this case, it happens to be all of the podcasts. I didn't want to use their data. And then we said we're going to take all of the other fields and add them up into the page area. So I'll take the keywords up and then all of these little checkboxes. They basically had checkboxes for, you know, for example, charts, VBA, pivot table, data analysis, formulas, formatting, printing, whether it was about Excel 2007 or not, which book it was from. Now, the error date, the error date is an interesting one because it would be too specific. I'm going to take the error date here to the left column temporarily, choose one of these error dates, right click, group and show detail, group, and group that up to months and years. Click OK. Now that those are grouped, I'm going to take those up to the page field as well. So we have error date and years. And basically, now what we have is we have an ad hoc reporting tool. If I want to see a list of just the podcast episodes that, for example, are about pivot tables, I would go here, choose just the X, and now my list of 600 and some podcast episodes is reduced just down to the ones about pivot tables. Maybe I want to see just the pivot tables that are about Excel 2007. So I go open that, and I get a nice short list of just the items from that specific area. Now, the one thing that was really strange, if we scroll to the right here, you'll see that there's a huge empty data area. It looked really strange, and it just took up a lot of space. And we said, well, okay, how can we make that data area not appear the way that it's appearing? So we took the title, which is a text field, and put it in the data area, which forces Excel to count. All right, and we kind of try to sell this to the manager saying, hey, in addition to giving you a list right down here now in the grand total, you'll see a count of how many items matched. So for pivot tables, Excel 2007, there were 11. But if we go back to all Excel 2007 and then choose just charts, click X, you'll see that there were only 3 episodes that are about charting in Excel 2007. So kind of a very unusual pivot table. And that most of the time, what we care about in the pivot table is here in the data area. But in this case, because we're interested in text, the real use of this pivot table is what's in the row area, those list of titles that match certain criteria that are up here in the page fields. I thought that was a very unique use of pivot tables, and glad I was able to help Terry out with that question, and passing it on to you in case you ever have a situation where you basically have a lot of text, want to show the results in a pivot table, and make use of the pivot table's drop down features up in the page field area. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.